Hey, it's Magnus here, and today we are making this spinner from scratch. Right, let's design and cut this spinner. Now, where I am right now is the new workshop, the one I'm sort of slowly but surely moving into. The other workshop is this one. So what we're gonna do is design, or should I say draw, the spinner on the computer here. And once I've done that, going to cut it on this machine. This is a water jet cutter. So, you know, high pressure water using garnet, which is, which I'll show you, this stuff here. Basically very fine sand, and that's what gets blasted through the sort of nozzle at the end with water at twice the speed of sound, yes, something like 1500 miles an hour or something, and that's what cuts the titanium. Right, let's get designing. And that is the design, pretty much done. Nice and simple, just mucking about. It's not a proper design, just something to play with. So what I'm gonna do now is find some titanium. Oh, some here. Whoa, that's 4 mil. Don't want 4 mil. We want 8 millimeter thick titanium. So we can find some over here. Got loads of the stuff. There we go, 8 mil. You can see, if you've been following my videos, you'll know I've cut various other prototypes and stuff over the last few weeks, and so you can see those shapes there. So if you're a subscriber and you've been subscribed for a while to this channel, you will be familiar with those shapes. And there we have it. One water jet cut spinner. Granted, it is very rough. I mean, I've still got to grind the edges and all that sort of stuff, but that's what I'm gonna go to the old workshop for now. Right, time to get sanding. Okay, so that is the edges beveled, corners beveled, and the flats sanded. Give you a quick look at that. Now, as you can see, in there is still very raw looking. So what I have to do now is on this grinder here, we have a wheel that's called a Scotch-Brite wheel. It's like a magic wheel, it really is. It takes a lot of material off, but also leaves it very smooth. You know, it's not like sandpaper where you have really rough sandpaper that really takes material off, but it leaves a rough finish. This Scotch-Brite wheel made by 3M is unreal. It's just, yeah, it's like magic. Oh, where am I going? I need to grind this. Okie dokie, right. Actually, you're probably hearing a lot of noise. That is the rain, so if that's coming through, my apologies for the poor sound quality, but not much I can do. That's it done. So, let's take a look at it. Now it is very, very raw, unfinished. I would usually tumble it, but today I'm not going to. So we'll put the core in it, press that in. We have liftoff. There we go, look at that. Will it spin? That's pretty damn good. Now it takes a little while to sort of get used to a spinner and just sort of try it out and things like that, but yeah, it's not too bad. Now, you know, again, this is just me mucking around, you know. It's too big, it's too chunky. These sort of scallops in here, they're way too far away. They need to be closer down to the core. So yeah, but still pretty good. Now I'll be honest, between this one and the one I did, I think was it yesterday or the day before, I can't remember, the other chunky one, I'm really starting to like heavy spinners. I was never into them before, but you know, since I made that one like this kind of size just for a muckabout, I was playing with it pretty much all day today, or most of the day. It was quite you know a good spinner when you don't have it with you and you have this urge to just have it, like if you know it's out of reach, you've got this sort of hankering for it. That's, I find, a sign of a good spinner. Man, I can't stop playing with this thing. Now, before I go, check the link in the description where you can sign up to sort of like an exclusive kind of launch list for the other spinner that I'm developing. You'll sort of get behind the scenes things and early bird access to various stuff I'm doing in the background that I don't show on YouTube. And with that, I will leave you with a quote. It is by Paul Arden, and he said, "Do not seek praise, seek criticism."